Hello YouTube, I do hope that you are doing well today. I just finished viewing a video due to a subscriber's recommendation, which is titled The Problem with Many Black People from the YouTuber Painlessrisen, yet another heavily flawed production. The reason I am addressing this dribble is because I was requested to, and the request came from a long-time subscriber of mine. So, therefore, I will take the time to make this video before I take my break. I am addressing this because I believe indifference invites severe consequences, and we cannot allow certain narratives to go unchallenged. Also, and I must add this for the sake of being completely honest with you, my audience, that I do not like snake oil salesmen that proclaim that what they do is for the sake of waking up a people. Of course, this claim is to act as protection from systematic investigation of their activity, of Painless, in this case, of his claims. I comprehend Painless will consider my words as stating a whole lot of nothing and using puffed-up language. This matters not. What matters is your consideration of my words and the fact this will be present for future reference. Surely no one who has enjoyed the pleasures of various literary works would waste the title Uncle Tom on Painlessrisen. We know, Painless, you are tap dancing for multiple reasons. What is completely revolting about the likes of you is not the so-called mirror you hold up to the so-called black community. The vessel from which truth comes from matters not. It is, among other things, your insistent need to use appeal to probability and fallacy of composition, so you gather approval via diverting from conformity to actuality. It is your right-wing partiality, coupled with your ineffectual drill sergeant persona. No one has to read into your intentions. If one thing is clear, and it is definitely clear, it is your ability to demonstrate the sickness which is rife in our society. You are eager to take your superficial and relative knowledge and pass it off as if it is verified information. You have provided enough factual evidence to show us who you are. It is not that you target a white audience. It is your prerogative to run your channel as you select. It is that you secretly desire to target those that you do, which paints you as one who is willing to swindle to feed your fraudulent scheme. Also, your theatrical performance may be opaque to some, it is not for others. Your desire to incite controversy rather than stimulate thought-provoking discussion that leads to expansion of being, is contemptible, in my opinion. We know you are giving the people what they want or have come to expect of you. They reward you by feeding your ego in your comment section. Does this intoxicate you, Painless? I am sure it does. Indeed, you have found your set of like minds, or inquisitive viewers. A specific audience that, for the most part, yearns to state what you, their black mouthpiece, articulates. Ones that delight in the shelter the spokesperson provides. The contentment they must feel for having one to co-sign on their unsavory thoughts. When rationality is abandoned, one can count on predictable expectations from the performer, that being you, Painless. One that will welcome a standard set of talking points and specific claims. Claims that frequently orbit around incomplete and inconsistent comparisons and that are visited and revisited and revisited. Do note that as an observer, I have been careful not to presuppose the objectivity of my own perspective when analyzing your behavioral events. I attempt to go where the information leads me. I, unlike you, make daily efforts to divorce myself from bias. Now, that probably shouldn't be said because I don't know exactly what you do on a daily basis. But this is an articulated belief and an opinion. We'll leave it at that, okay? If this is a practice of yours, however, it is not available for view. What has been noted are your racially skewed arguments, playing on white people's fears, and providing masturbation material for those who have forcible subjugation fantasies, or reinforcing the moronic race realist position of various speculations as to why, supposedly, that blacks lag behind their white counterparts. Such collectivist views are sickening, yet your contribution to the silliness that natural selection never acted on blacks the way it did a person of mixed European and Asian descent, well, it's just disgusting. These fools fail to get, somewhat like you, Painless, that the ability to delay gratification, save for the future, etc., is not a group sport. Many black individuals have shown an ability over the years, without resorting to destructive acts, to survive very harsh environments. Yet your rhetoric acts as a nutrient medium for these unsavory sorts so that they can produce something from their mental investments. Though you label yourself an agnostic, I rightfully claim that I liken you, due to examination of your ideas, to a fundamentalist whose sacred text is the GOP rhetoric and the ultra-conservative spin, seasoned heavily with self-hate, though you no doubt see it as breaking from the liberal dogma. Addressing some of the points that you made in your video, you made a comment regarding the fact that, generally speaking, that African culture was primitive. Well, that's just downright fallacious. Obviously, you have not studied the tribes of West Coast Africa. Guinea Coast areas, I see you made no mention of. How convenient, Painless. Why would you make such a statement but fail to mention that areas like Guinea had formalized and highly complex social, political, and economic institutions? Was it just a matter of convenience that you forgot this? What about the intricacies of their theology and the variety of artistic expression? Expression that shows that though some may consider them to be primitive, their function was anything but. But I guess that's what you get when you lack careful thought, huh, Painless? I suggest that you read West Africa, The Complexities of Primitive Cultures by William R. Bascom, capital B-A-S-C-O-M. Maybe you'll learn something. The primitive culture may have contributed to one being able to be deceived. That is correct, as you were making reference to how blacks were duped into slavery. Well, I don't buy that. We weren't just duped in our ancestors, that is, into slavery. Ultimately, it was interpretations regarding standards of behavior, catering to sadistic yearnings and desire for wealth and services without compensation that won out. This has to do primarily with lack of integrity. You really should dig deeper, Painless, before making such idiotic claims. Jumping on to another point that you made in your video. So the liberal movement made blacks arrogant, self-important, so self-important that they felt entitled to anything, huh? How absolutely preposterous. Your subjective stance aside, it is obvious that you are not solely addressing blacks, therefore you are mislabeling them. It is your abandonment of the fact that these attributes are woven into the human consciousness. Some individuals are better at contending with these challenges than others. Obviously, this entitlement is obvious when you examine that nobody wants to give up their stuff. Look at our corrupt and power-hungry regulators for proof of this. Or our congressional leaders with their no-term limits and pork projects. Or our ridiculously overcompensated celebrities. This is not limited to an ethnicity or a racial group. So stop with the claim that this is a problem with many black people. No, this is just a problem that runs rampant within humanity, especially those on the Western side of the world. Anyone who has observed closely America can make a really good argument that America is saturated in an entitlement culture. If this was not true, we would not require so many things has to be inclusive. Political correct speech is great for this. It matters not if you look at the private and public sectors, the public schools, pop culture, or how the quote-unquote typical American generates a general inclusive concept of capitalism. You see, you are far from the only black person who has witnessed how the welfare state has undermined the formation of the traditional two-parent family. And I would say this was done due to weak constitution or severe economic need and not something which is racially inherent. Though traditional, as it relates to traditional families, traditional two-parent families, does not equate to better or as efficient as a parent, a single parent, or an unorthodox coupling of parents of high quality. Or, for example, that admitting students, just to give you something else to think about, under race-based preferences, tends to produce a higher dropout rate. Though it is rarely mentioned that even if this was true, that for the ones that do succeed, that under the admittance of educational institutions that may employ affirmative action, the student must consistently demonstrate an ability to thrive in the environment they have residence. Going to another point, you're thinking that blacks have a propensity for illogical thinking and conflict resolution. Oh my goodness. This is nothing more than your personal cognitive content that you hold as true. Your broad brush lacks the ability to attend to areas that require attention to detail. Oh, and the willingness of a black person to shoot another black person over something that one may deem as being inconsequential has to do with lack of personal development. Personal development. Will you please just stop with the sham contentious speech? You are doing nothing more than subjugating the individual to your speculative group flaw. When will you ever look beyond the surface, Painless? People like you are the reason I ceased debating long ago, for it is obvious that you do not look for truth, for you are too deeply entrenched in dogma. What is telling is how some people are fooled by assertions. People seem to forget, and it is obvious from your typical commenter ones that I have read, that frequently this is used as a veiled appeal to authority. You see, the assumption is made the person making the assertion, which would be you, is an expert or has a position of unassailable formal authority. This is especially true of people who supposedly hold a mirror to a particular group, in your case a racial group, but probably have not engaged in this activity personally. What is more pathetic is how a certain type of black person is won over by general productions of rubbish, especially the unique ones that you produce. As one of my subscribers so eloquently pointed out, it is sad when a sizable portion of blacks have become the comfortable because they pose no ideological threat, comfortable, useful idiots of people who couldn't care less about them. Thank you for your time.